My name is Susie Ammer. I'm the head golf professional at a golf course in Denver. And I've been a head golf professional or general manager since 2008. As the general manager or head professional, you kind of run the whole day-to-day operations of the club. You manage your staff of about 40 people, both outside staff, inside staff. You run the day-to-day in terms of business at the golf course and people coming to play golf and people coming to visit your facility for different reasons. So I kind of oversee all of our staff and what they're doing on a day-to-day basis. The other part of the job is the big picture of doing budgets and paying bills and doing different things that require back-of-the-house type projects. Well, at my particular facility, I'm the only female, so the rest of the staff is male. But I feel capable and confident to do any job that they're required to do or that they're asked to do, whether it's checking people in, cleaning carts, setting the golf course up for the day, merchandising, marketing, anything that they're asked to do, I've done or I do on a regular basis. Well, that's a good question. Society seems to think that beverage cart drivers on golf courses should be female, and that people who do the merchandise in the pro shop or set up the displays or sell the apparel or sell things in the shop should be female. At our particular facility, all of our beverage cart drivers are female. And again, that's on the restaurant side. On the golf side, again, I'm the only female and I do all the different tasks. So I was working at a course and we had a group of four golfers that were, they were drunk and they were being disorderly on the golf course and had driven their carts in an area they weren't supposed to. And when our marshal went up and asked them to move and to kind of get themselves together and be respectful, they talked back and said, "We'll send your boss out here and we'll see what we have to say to him." And so our marshal came in and said, "These guys want to talk to you." And so when I went out there and pulled up, I said, "Is there a problem? Is there something going on that we need to talk about?" And the one gentleman said, "Well, you're a female. You're not the boss." And I said, "Well, actually I am." And again, that kind of diffused things and it took him by surprise that there would be a female in my role, and he kind of changed his tune really quickly. I think it's beneficial because, as I've alluded to it before, people don't expect to see a female in this role, and it kind of diffuses people when they're really mad to come in and think they're going to yell at a man and or yell at a kid or a boy. To have them come in and see a female standing there, it diffuses them and it kind of eases the tension a little bit. I'd say the biggest detriment is kind of the same thing, that, what is the detriment? That sometimes people might not take you as seriously because you're a female in a role that's expected to be taken by a man. And so sometimes you get that impression that they're not taking you as seriously because you are a female. I think out of the 200 and plus courses in Colorado, there's probably 5 or 6 females that are head professionals or general managers. And I think the reason for that is that there aren't as many qualified candidates who are females, but if they do apply and if they are qualified and they have the right credentials, they definitely get a shot at jobs. We just need more females to apply for those jobs. So I want more females to interview and to get qualified and to get hired in these roles, because it definitely creates a different atmosphere in golf shops. It creates a different atmosphere on golf courses when there's a female running the show. I mean, I think that it takes people by surprise and it calms them down to know that there's a female in charge, and it's not such a good old boys organization that's very stereotypical in golf.